Alright guys, we're going to take a look at another XTOOL diagnostic scan tool today. This one, it's the D7. Now, I've already done a video about the D8, and this one is basically an inch smaller. It's a tablet style scan tool, and let's get the box open and check it out. Okay, so right off the bat here, we got owner's manual and some registration information, and we got the data cable. We've got the OBDII connector for the end of the data cable. We've got the power supply, which it has an extra end with it, so you can either use for North America or overseas, but we're in the U.S., so we're going to use this. And then, of course, the it's a USB charging cable that plugs into the power brick there. And that's about it for that stuff. And of course, we got the scan tool itself. Now again, this is the D7. It has, on the top, it has the data cable connector, USB port, looks like a microphone hole, a power button, and on this one, there is no camera on the back. Let's get it powered on and check it out. All right, so here it is, the XTOOL D7. I've got it all hooked up. And if you watch the D8 video that I put out earlier, you'll see that it basically has the same screen, and it operates the same. I see the difference between the D8 and the D7 as, obviously, it's 1 inch smaller. It has a smaller battery. On the back, there is no brace or a bracket that you can hang on a steering wheel or set it at an angle on your desk. And there's no camera. But other than that, oh, here, I must have hit something. Other than that, I believe it has almost the exact same functionality. So it is a wired-only device. It does not have Bluetooth connection to the vehicle. And like I said in the other video, there is some pros to being a wired device, meaning there's some latency and some delay if you have a Bluetooth connection, and a wired connection is typically, or can be typically, faster. And the other thing is, you know, a wired connection helps keep the cost down. So, you know, if someone was looking for a very capable scan tool for a very reasonable price, you know, this is probably going to be the one, because it's quite a bit cheaper than the D8 or other comparable scan tools, but it has pretty much all functionality. We're going to go through and see what it has, but other than the EC or the ECU eeprom coding, this thing does everything the D8 does. So let's check it out. We'll go into diagnosis here. We'll go to the VIN. We'll go to auto scan. And we're going to. That's right. Traction control, automatic. That's correct. And so if we go to auto, if you can see here, if we go to auto diagnose, that's going to be where it scans. It'll scan through all the modules in the vehicle and give you all the trouble codes for everyone, if there is. We'll just go to system diagnose here. And you'll see that in this 2006 GMC pickup, it'll show you pretty much every module in this vehicle. So let's do it a powertrain, for example. We'll go to live data. Well, engine live data 2, just for, you know, example. This is going to look pretty much like the screen on the D8. If you guys want to check out that video, I'll put a link up here in the top corner. Otherwise, I'll do a link down below in the video description for you to check that out. But this shows all the PIDs for my engine live data. You know, if the computer is monitoring it, it's going to show it on this screen. We can go to engine live data 1. Some of these live data PIDs are redundant. It'll show them on both pages for this particular vehicle. So here it is. So for example, say you wanted to, we'll just pick engine speed here, and say you wanted to, you can start data recording that. Or you could do a graph. I'll rev it up here. It'll start graphing it out for you. And you can do this graphing with any of the PIDs in here. Let's go back and see what this has for bidirectional control. So we'll go activation tests, engine. We can turn, if it was a diesel, we could turn the glow plugs on and off, turn the air conditioning pump on and off, you know, the fuel pump on and off. We can, I mean, all everyone, like engine fans, you know, I can either turn on engine fan 1, engine fan 2, or engine fan 1, 2, and 3. We'll give that a try here, just for an example. It takes a second for it to connect. And we'll hit the on button. I just turned off the fan for the AC, the climate control was on. I just turned that off. Hopefully you guys didn't hear that in the video. But the engine fans, all three of the engine fans are on now, if you can hear them. And now I'll turn them off. If you heard that or not. But so all of these bidirectional controls function. So let's try the AC relay just for fun. Turn the AC pump on. And it came on. Now we'll turn it off. And it shut off. Let's, just for fun, let's go out of here, out of the powertrain, and we'll go and do another one here. Let's try the body control module. Actuation tests. You can do the horn. You can do a light test. I think that's the, is that the light test for the, oh, yeah, parking lights, daytime running lights, backup lamps. You can turn all your lights on and off to test them. And, you know, it's not about being able to turn them on and off with your scan tool. Yeah, that sounds cool and everything, but it's about being able to diagnose an electrical problem. You know, for example, say your parking lamps. If your parking lamps didn't work, you know, or say your backup lamps. Backup lamps might be a better example. If your backup lamps didn't work, well, if you're able to turn them on here, then you know the wiring going to the backup lamp is good. But if it doesn't work when you put your transmission or your gear shifter into reverse, you know, maybe you got a bad shifter cable is out of adjustment, or maybe you've got a bad neutral safety switch, or so, you know, whatever it could be. You know, it just gives you a tool to help you diagnose what a problem could be. And so let's try left rear window, for example. Let's hit the down button. Hopefully you guys could hear that window open. Some outside noise is coming in from the highway next door. Hit the up button. Window went up. We'll go back to the main screen and go to special functions. I forget the exact number of special functions that they advertise for the D7, but let's see. It's 25, I guess. 25 are on the screen here. If not, I'll look it up and put the number right here, and we'll know for sure. But as you can see, there's plenty of options here for special service functions. It's pretty, it's a pretty complete scan tool, really, for the money. It's not bad. And of course, updates, one-touch updates. If I've already updated this tool, but if there was any updates whatsoever, again, it just goes on your Wi-Fi at home or where your office, your shop, whatever. You click one button and it updates it like that. No piece of cake. And as far as updates are concerned, I mean, they're putting out updates all the time. They're refining this scan tool on a daily, all of XTOOL scan tools, they're refining on a daily basis. I mentioned in my D8 video that, you know, if you find a glitch or something isn't functioning just right, you know, just send XTOOL an email and they'll do a software patch for you and send it right out. Well, that actually, after I got done filming that video, that actually happened. I found something with the alcohol, the fuel composition reset wasn't functioning correctly for this particular 2006 GMC truck. And I sent the Amazon seller an email, and I'd have to look at the email, the return email, but I bet it was less than 24 hours later. The seller said they contacted the engineer or the engineering department, the tech people, and they had already fixed it, and for me to go and download the update. And sure enough, I turned on the D8, and the update was there, downloaded it, and everything worked just great. So I'm not saying every time it's going to be less than 24 hours, but that's a good example of how well they're trying to perfect these and refine these and get these, you know, these tools working just as good as they possibly can. So if you find something, you know, glitchy, because, you know, like I said before, there's no perfect scan tool. They've all got their problems, even the most expensive ones you can buy. So, but the difference is, will the manufacturer help you out when you do find those glitches? And XTOOL has been really good. The two times I have found a glitch, they've had it fixed within a couple of days, or even that last time within 24 hours. So it was pretty amazing. But so then there's the extended functions. There's xCloud. I'm not sure what the xCloud is. Maybe you can store files and data on a cloud. I'm not sure. I don't think it's anything I would use. And then, of course, we've got settings for the, these are the settings for the actual diagnostic software in the XTOOL tablet. There's also settings for the Android portion. There's also settings right here for the tablet itself. But like I said, this is these are the settings for the XTOOL software. And then updates, like I showed you, there's no updates. Special functions, we already looked at those. Report, this would be if you're using this in a shop setting, if you want to print out a report of any trouble codes you found on a customer's vehicle, and you could have, you know, you could maybe put your company name and information on it. Would look real official when you hand the customer a report that gets generated from this device. Pretty handy to have. And of course, remote control here. Again, if just like the D8, if you needed someone from XTOOL to remote into your device and be able to help you along with something, they could do that from this function right here. So I have not showed you the auto scan yet. Let's take a look at that quick. So go to auto diagnose. This is where it's going to scan every module within the vehicle. There it goes. And like I said before, the powertrain one on this particular vehicle is a bad oil pressure sensor. But anyway, I'm not going to bore you with this. This could take quite a few minutes, depending on how many modules your vehicle has. It can be either quicker or slower than this. I mean, it goes through them fairly quick. Like you look down here, it's already number 10 of 28. So, you know, not too bad. But I'm going to pause this for now so we can wrap it up here. Anyway, this is a very nice scan tool for the money. If you're looking for a tablet-style scan tool that's very reasonably priced for the type of functionality that it has, this is probably the way to go right here. So anyhow, there's our look at the D7 diagnostic scan tool by XTOOL. If you want a tablet style, if you want the most functionality for the money, this might be the way to go. Check it out. All right, guys. That's about it. Be sure to subscribe, like, and share this video. Thanks for watching.